Hey there, it's Jeff here in the Idea Lab. We're going to try and figure out how to put together our Star Trek Enterprise kit. A lot of pieces to this one, but I don't think it'll be too hard to get this together. So for the first part, I'm going to start with the saucer section here. You'll have a bunch of these little yellow pegs on a brim. They'll just peel off of the brim. You see how that wants to just peel away like that? We're going to need, I think, four of them for this part. We're kind of starting with the underside here. So four of these little yellow guys. Two of these little triangles here. We got these tiny rounded rectangles there. Two medium curves and one long curve. And I think that's everything for the inside of the saucer section here. I've also got, now this is theoretically supposed to go together without glue. I shouldn't need any glue here, but I have some super glue just in case. And I also have a little razor knife here that I can use to kind of like clean up some of the edges of these parts that maybe were on brims or that were printing flat. So I can kind of clean that up. Instead of a razor knife, you could also use a nail file, a little bit of sandpaper. You've got lots of options. Like here, let me grab a nail file. I'll show you how I would use one of these. So like this long piece, it's got a little bit of a sharp edge here. So I can just kind of take my little nail file, clean that edge up a little bit. May not be necessary, but just as a means of demonstrating. Sandpaper would work here. A metal file would work. Let's smooth that up a little bit. So, this piece, you can see we've got these slots here. This piece is supposed to press into place here. And everything should theoretically be just a press fit. So, see how I've got that nice and flush in there? It goes in, you know, a certain depth and it won't go any farther. So we're going to kind of repeat that with the other ones. Now there's polarity to these things. There's a left and a right side. And I'm pressing the flat part. If you look at this, there's like a chamfered top edge and then there's a flat bottom part. I'm doing all these flat part down for this. And we're going into the top section here of the Enterprise. So, do the same thing with all of these. Just press all these in there. Seems good. Now I've got these two little triangles. Again, there's a slightly chamfered top and a very, very flat bottom. So I'm doing the flat part down, leaving the chamfer facing upward. Some of these might need a little help to fit. We'll see. Let's try this one over here. This one just doesn't quite want to go. Let's see. Maybe we need to shave this one down a bit. I'm going to try taking my X-Acto knife here and just trimming the tip of this one a little bit. Let's see if that helps any. Oh, yeah. There we go. That helped a lot. I'm gonna do the same thing with this one. Just shaving a little bit off the tip here. This is a great design. I really love how the designer intended for all of this to be put together. It's not didn't really come with any instructions of any kind, so we're sort of on our own to figure out how this is going to work. There we go. Both of those are in there. Now, this little white peg here, that's gonna press down into the center. So you see how it's got like a flat part and a round part? We're doing the round part up here. So this is just gonna press into place there. And we've got a bunch of these little yellow pegs. Not sure how necessary these are, but we're gonna pop all of these in place. Again, flat side down. Okay, excellent. Now, for the bottom half of our saucer section, there's a few parts that are going in here. So we've got these little round, kind of slightly curved, rectangular pieces. Now, on these, you're going to look for a shiny side. That one's got kind of a very, very smooth side and a slightly rougher side. You can see that pattern. That's the top there. And then this one doesn't have that rippled pattern to it, so that's the bottom. So the smooth side is going down. And these should only fit in here one way. Those are just going to kind of press into place here. Not entirely sure which is the right and which is the left, but we're gonna figure it out. Now, I wonder if these would be easier to put in after the rest of this gets sandwiched together. Let's hold off on those for a second. I'm gonna try these out. Similar thing here, smooth side, slightly rougher side. We're doing smooth side down. These are popping into these tiny indents here on the side. Smooth side down. Just needs a little bit of cleanup in here. This is something you may encounter with your kit. Some of the undersides may need a little bit of help. That looks okay. Okay, let's see if these will go together now. Kind of using the that center tall peg as a guide. Try and push the whole thing together. Pretty solid press fit here. Cool. I'm just using both of my palms to kind of like get this all pressed together. Holy cow, look at that. That's awesome. Now let's try these little guys. Again, smooth side down, and they'll only fit in here one way. Go ahead and try and. Ha, yeah, they popped right in there. Excellent. Yeah, these ones were definitely easier to do after the whole thing goes together like this. Awesome. Love it. Hefty. Very good quality here on the build. Let's see. The last thing is the top sensor section. Tiny little white pebble here. That's just going to plug right into this little feature on the top there. So, other than the placards, I believe that is the top done. Oh no, wait, there's some parts on the back. So you're gonna have a bunch of these little tiny guys here. Yours might also be on a brim, like mine are on a brim. I think we got a little too many of these, so you might have some extras here. So these are just supposed to slot back in here. A little dubious about these fitting. See how there's some filament kind of hanging down there? I'm gonna just take my razor knife, kind of try to clean some of that up. So there's maybe not quite as much of that hanging down. And let's see if these press into place. These were kind of optional parts anyway. Yep, they'll go. Seems to be in there. Try this one. Seems pretty good. This is where some of that glue might come in handy, but it's not falling out, so I think that's just fine. Cool. Now we've got our little badges that go on here. We got a couple here, and we've got our big curved one. So the main curved badge is going to press into there. That's not the greatest fit. It's a little loose. I think I might use some glue here. Let's put just a little dot of glue there. And for the sake of this video, I'm going to use some of this glue accelerator on this part. That'll just speed things along. Press that in there, hold that for a second. That should be good now. Look at how nice that looks. Now we've got two on the bottom here, and I believe they both go like this. I can't remember if it's like that or like this, but I guess it could be either. You could do it one way and the other. Hang on, I'm gonna go consult the picture of the model. I'll be right back. Okay, from looking at the picture, they go like this. And that's a nice press fit. I don't think I need glue for that one. That one also fits great. No glue needed there, at least not for my application. And look at this. This is already really taking shape. Cool. Let's figure out the rest. We've got this part here, part of the hull. We've got this part here. This is probably next, is my guess. We've got this thing. Pretty sure this kind of slides into here. Oh, yeah, definitely. That's a very nice fit there. And then this thing, I am fairly certain, kind of goes together and pops in there. And to hold this guy together, there's a couple of pieces. So first, let's look at our the sides of these have a couple slots where these very cool red and kind of gunmetal gray badges go into. So these are gonna pop into here. Seems like a very nice fit. And we're going to do the other one on the other side. Yep, that seems like it's in there. I don't think that's coming out. Cool. Looks great. And then our little what do you call this? The deflector array, I think. That is gonna plug into place here. And I'd be extra careful with this one. You see how it's got really thin shapes here? So I'm gonna do my best to not break this by pushing kind of only from the sides here. Let's see if I can get it in on one. And then get the other one to pop in next to it. Ooh, I don't know. This one's kind of tricky. It's making me nervous. Probably a better way to do this. Gonna try and pop this back out. Because I really don't want to break it. This little red thing is one of my favorite pieces. There we go. So let's see. What's the deal here? What's the best way to make this fit? I'm gonna do a little bit of cleanup. It seems like there's plenty of clearance, but just in case, I'm gonna take my little razor knife and I'm gonna clean up around the bottom of here. Also gonna kind of want to try and clean this up some too. This might be the best tool for the job. My little nail file. Kind of just try and polish that up a little bit. I'm going to do the same thing for the other one. It looks pretty good. I mean, I don't think that's really what's interfering, but just think this might work better. Hang on a second. I think my microphone is dying. Okay, I got my microphone plugged in. I was getting the flashing red light of doom. So let's see if this works any better now. Oh, yeah, a little bit. Okay. Yes. Good. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. I really want to just kind of like, push it, but I think that would break it. So kind of just using my fingers to push around the outside rim, that seems to be doing the trick. Yes. Good. That's looking great. And then the back half of this piece is gonna plug into this slot on here. Okay, that totally broke when I tried to plug this in here. So, glue. We're gonna use glue. I'm gonna take some of this, just put a little bit around the outside here, spray a little of my accelerator on there. I'm just going to keep this held down for a second or two here. Oh, yep, that was all it took. Cool. Now this part should press up into here. That. Whoa, it's really taking shape. That looks awesome already. I love this. Okie dokie, now to the nacelles. These are our little nacelle buddies here. Now these, there's two of them that will go together to make two symmetrical parts like this. It looks like this might be where our last two of our little alignment pegs are going to come in handy. So I'm going to separate my final alignment pegs from their little brim that they were on. Kind of clean these up a little bit here. Those look good. This hole also looks like it needs a little cleanup. Much better. Now let's try popping one peg, pressing it firmly. Went in a little cockeyed. There we go. Nice. And then these two should press together, just like that. Okay. Let's see. Now these go here like that, and then there's a sort of a front section. I think this. Yeah, this is gonna pop on here once it's attached to here. And I think our red circle pieces attach to that. So let's start by doing these side sections here. Oh, I got these wrong. Here's something to pay attention to. Don't make my mistake. There are two sides, and the two sides are different. One's got a very wide slot, and the other's got a narrow slot. And those match up with each other like that. Wide slot and narrow slot. That way, these things can pop into one side, and these super cool things can pop into the other side. But let's make sure we get this right. I'm pretty sure that, yes, these go on the outside. Yep, that's plugged into here. That's going to plug in there. So, yep, I'm confident enough. I can press this into place. Nice fit on that one. Now this one, I can't remember if it goes like this or like this. Let me go look at the picture. I'll be right back. Okay, so this goes like this, and that means that this little fin is going to be at the front here. Bit of a tight fit, this one. There we go. Awesome. That's what we want to see on that one. And then the other thing, this other one, is the same thing, just the mirror image. So this part is gonna go here. Seems like with these, it's good to get one side pressed in and then work the rest of the way down. Cool, that looks awesome. Love the kind of powder blue element there. And then we've got our other little badge here. Nice and easy fit there. Cool. Now then, this presses onto here like that, and this little guy, these are the same for the left and right side. This is going to kind of hold it all together by pressing onto here gently so we don't break it. Just going to kind of wiggle it into place. There we go. Boom. Excellent, and we can put our little dot on there. This is really coming together. Okay. Yes, that's looking very nice indeed. And then I think the only thing left is this little guy, this little thing which fits on the end here. And that completes one nacelle. So we're gonna gently turn it around and do the same thing for this nacelle. Put that on there. Very gently wiggle this into place. Great. Push our little red warp engine highlight there. Looking good. And then our final little beveled piece on the back here. Okay. Awesome. There it is. The Enterprise. And it does have a stand too. So let's see if we can get it on its stand. It's got this really neat stand. It's got a little bit of stringing on it. Let me see here. I'm gonna see if I can adjust my camera angle a little bit. There we go. Okay, so this should theoretically just kinda plug down onto there. Oh, yep, there it goes. Whoa, whoa. I mean, just wow. Look at how good that looks. Okay, I love it. Big Star Trek fan here. Always loved it. Super happy to be offering this really awesome model kit to you. I hope you have fun putting it together. Thanks for figuring it out with me. It's exciting building something without any instructions whatsoever. Luckily, this one's designed in such a way that that's a pretty straightforward thing to do. Thanks for being troopers and doing this with me. If you have any questions, any issues putting this together, missing pieces, anything like that, give us a call, shoot us an email. We're happy to help figure it out with you. We'll see you for next month's kit. One last little addendum here. I realized as soon as I stopped taking the video that I had my nacelles swapped. The little badge should be on the outside. Just watch for that when you're putting yours together.